Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. So here we'll take a look how to pass parameters and arguments to GoRouter. And this is what we built last time. We can click on them and go to a new page. You can push them, come back, go model, pop up, things like that. Okay, so here I had this GoRouter initial path, and these are the kind of subroutes we had. Now we'll see how to pass parameters and arguments to it. So first we'll take this one, this route over here, subroute. And over here, we want to pass, as we go to a new page, we want to pass a parameter to it, okay? Now, to be able to do that, you can name the parameter anything you want, but you have to start with slash and then this colon and the name ID, okay? This one you have to put. Now, at the same, pass this to the screen or page where you want to go. So over here, we would do ID. And then we have to, now inside this, we have to use the object, which is called state. Now state is this one, this object over here. And it has a property called params. Okay, now inside this, you have to grab the name, okay? So this is the name that you want to grab. And then over here, you are saying that, okay, this is not going to be null, okay? Now we have this error over here because in the detail screen, in the constructor, we also need to have a related ID or variable. So here we'll declare variable final string ID, and now here we say that this is required, this dot ID. Now the error should be gone. Let's come over here. So this is in the route itself, but how about actually passing the value? Because over here we are saying that, hey, I'm going to pass it to you and grab this, whatever is this, is over here. And then we will pass it down to the screen, but from where to pass? Okay, now we'll pass it from the place where we trigger this event, like going to a new page. So we have to find this place over here, like we click on this button, and as we click, we have to pass the value. Let's go ahead and do that. So now over here, this is the place that I think we can pass. So over here, what we'll do, definitely we can call context.go, and then we just simply do like this detail, okay? So it will take us to detail page. But what about actually passing the value? So we have to pass the value from here. So over here, first we can generate a random value, and we'll save it in a variable called ID. And for this reason over here, we are going to use random function of dart, and then it has another helper function which is called next int. So we'll generate value 0 to 100, and as we generate the value, actually we'll pass it over here, okay? That's as simple as that one. So we generate the value and we pass it to this route over here. So as we click on this detail, we'll carry this value, and as it carries, it'll reflect over here and as well as over here, okay? So now let's go ahead and restart it. Now let's click on this one, first one. While we do have a bit of issues, the reason is over here, I forgot a slash actually. So we should have a slash like this, and then let's restart and it would work. Let's go ahead and check on this. Okay, here we see that we have this value 41, which has been randomly generated, okay? Of course, you can go back and you come and see that this is the value, okay? So the every time we get a new value. So that's first part of the puzzle. So all you need to do, so as you click on the button, the place where you click over there, you have to generate certain value. It could be dynamic value coming from your server, and just pass it down to context.go, context.push, it doesn't really matter. And as well as other two places, you have to make change, the go route itself, and inside the builder using the state object, you can actually grab them inside your page. Okay, great. Okay, next we'll see how to pass arguments. So that means that we are not going to do it from here. Actually, we are going to directly do it in our screen constructor. So model is a screen, okay? So over here we want to pass arguments. You can pass any kind of argument. Over here I call the argument name is blog. You can call it anything. And then once again we can grab this state object, and then it has another parameter, another property actually, that's called extra, okay? Now you would pass it like this. Now it could be any kind of string value, integer or object. Now in this case we are going to convert it to string, okay? Yeah, but we will still have error because we need to come to this model screen over here and we need to grab it over here, okay? All right, great. Now of course it's still not going to work. It's where we are pushing it, this the place where we are pushing it, this model path, this route over here, we also need to make changes. That means this button over here. Now the button, I think it's right over here, okay? So we also need to make changes in this place. But before we make changes, let's remove this arrow function and put it like this. And then we'll do like this, okay? Now here is the actual argument that you need to create and pass it to it. So we'll just simply call it blog and we'll call it cutie and that's all. It's a little different. So over here we'll take this one which is called extra and then we pass this blog, okay? And that's how it works. So if you want to pass arguments, you have to use this special property which is called extra. If you hover over on it, and you will see that you have this object which is called extra, okay? And now we are passing it and we are grabbing it inside this model screen, okay? And let's go ahead and restart our app and we'll see. Okay, so here is this, but of course we don't see any changes. The change is persistent over here, but for this one still not yet. But as you see, we pass it down, right? So we can actually use it right now. So we'll just simply go ahead and remove this and use it. Let's remove the const one. Okay, now let's restart our app. Now as we see that it took the value and we passed it to this next screen as an argument. So the idea is if you want to pass arguments in your context.go or context.push, you have to use the property called extra and the related value, whatever it is, you just pass it. And at the same time, in your go route, in your route, you have to also use or get it as a state object over here, okay, using the state value. Anyway, so if you learned something, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Thank you so much.